The Philippines' Taal volcano has slightly gone quiet Friday following the eruption the day before. State seismology agency FIVOC says no other phreatomagmatic event has so far been recorded on Taal volcano. Less earthquakes have also been detected. FIVOC adds it is not expecting any imminent major eruption.
Pagkatapos po nung apat na maliliit na pagsabog hanggang 200 metro ang taas kagabi, early evening, eh wala na pong sumunod. Ang makikita po natin ngayon ay yung paglabas ng maputing usok. May gas po dyan at water vapor na kadalasan ay pinapadpad po yan papuntang Timog, Kanluran or Southwest.
FIVOC says it continues to monitor Taal and observe for possible magmatic intrusion, which may cause a big eruption. On Thursday, FIVOC raised alert level 3 over the Taal volcano, which means there has been magmatic unrest at its main crater.
Ang susunod na mapangyari, kailangan subaybayan ng mabuti. Kasi kung meron pang umakyat na magma na maraming gas at hindi nakakalabas, ay posibleng tumuloy sa mas malakas-lakas na pagsabog. Yun po yung ating scenario. At siyempre, batay na rin sa ating monitoring yan. Kung sakali man, ay sana parang fireworks lang ng konti at lava lang ang labas. Pag ganun po ang higing sitwasyon, mas maigi po yan sa ating mga kababayan.
Disaster officials in Batangas preparing for a worst-case scenario as Alert Level 3 remains hoisted over Taal Volcano. The Provincial Disaster Risk Reduction and Management Office says 345 families who live in the danger zone are taking shelter in various evacuation centers across Batangas. Nearby provinces are also ready to help in case more people need to be evacuated.
Ang ibang provinces at Calabarzon like Cavite, Quezon and Laguna ay meron ding inilalaan na lugar. So yun is a worst case scenario kapag nag-escalate. Yung mga temporary treatment facility at yung mga isolation center labas ng Batangas ay nakalaan po na mag-accommodate kung sakasakaling magkakaroon po ng magpa-positive po sa COVID-19 yung ating mga kababayan.
The local government of Taal also prepared in case the situation around the volcano escalates. Mayor Fulgencio Mercado says the local government is now more equipped to handle a volcanic disaster following Taal's previous eruption in January last year. But he admits the pandemic might pose challenges to their evacuation efforts.
Yun ang mahirap talaga na mangyayari kasi katulad nga ng ginagawa ng ibang LGU na dapat naman na meron talaga antigen test ang mag-evacuate kasi baka magkahawahan sa evacuation center. Kasi tayo naman ay mapalad because ina-accommodate tayo ng bayan ng Bawan. Iyon ang ating pupuntahan in case of any eventuality at naka-ready na rin sila. But syempre, kailangan on our part ay kami na rin mismo ay mag-antigen sa mga kung sino mang pupunta sa ibang bayan. But the problem nga now is syempre medyo mahirap ding mag-acquire ng antigen at napakamahal din actually.
The governor of Batangas asks for more COVID-19 test kits from the national government. Governor Hermilando Mandana says this would help them screen evacuees better and in turn prevent a possible outbreak of COVID-19 in evacuation centers. Despite the situation in Taal, Mandana says most economic activities in Batangas continue.
The Batangas International Port, which is
the
biggest number of passengers, 3 times bigger than the Port of Manila, is not affected at all. So
that's
from an economic
know.
Point of view,
yes, sir.
Not much effect. More affected would be really the population.
The Philippine Board of Investment says it will try to finish by this year a set of guidelines that would help locators better respond to disasters, such as volcanic eruptions. Bobby Fondevilla of the BOI Investment Assistance Service says there are close to 60 housing, manufacturing, and exports firms within the Taal volcano's danger zone. He says government should be able to provide more support to those businesses even if they have their own continuity plans.
Part of the plan really is to really come up with something strong, like I'm talking about linkages amongst government agencies and maybe concerned private entities. We have to come up with a literature or a guideline that would really guide companies on what to do in case catastrophic events would happen like this one.